This video is a sequel to a video previously posted on this channel featuring other Joseph about how to get bad grades in law school. So you may want to check out that video before watching this one. Or you could just watch this one, either way. In that video, Joseph talks about his experience in law school and about the way that he goes about not giving his all for law school in order to give his all for other projects. As you stop and think about it, you may think, but wait a second, I don't need a YouTube video to tell me how to get bad grades in law school or any school. I know how to do that. You just don't go to class, don't do any of the homework, don't pay attention. And there, you've got your bad grades. It's super easy. But if you've watched that video, you know that what the other Joseph is trying to do is not just to get bad grades, but to get bad grades in a good, helpful, productive way. So this video is tackling that same problem, but from another angle, which is how to get good grades in a good, helpful, productive way. And you might think, well, wait a second, good grades are just good, helpful, and productive. There's no way about it. But if you stop and think about it, for instance, if you cheat and that's how you get good grades, that's not a good way to get good grades. It makes it so that your diploma is a lie, your knowledge is a lie, and you've got nothing. Another bad way to get good grades would be to study something that you don't care about and you're just studying it because you think it will make you a lot of money or because your parents want you to do it or because you feel like somebody else expects you to do it. That would be another way that you could get good grades, but it would be a bad way to get good grades. So the question that I want to talk to you about is how to get good grades in a good way. Now, this is a question that I've been obsessing about since I was in high school. That's about the time that I figured out that whenever I went through school, whatever classes I took and whatever area of study I chose to pursue, there would always be people who were expecting me to learn certain things, to say certain things, and to do things in a certain way. And it was also about that same time when I started to realize that I wanted to make sure that I lived my life in a way that I approved of and that I could do sincerely and full-heartedly. And so the question was, okay, how am I now going to go through high school and college and all of these courses and everything that everyone is going to expect of me through the educational system and come out having accomplished my own goals, having fully integrated that and instead of doing it for someone else, do it for me? So I want to share a few tips that I've learned having wrapped up high school, yes, and also an undergraduate degree and also a graduate degree. One thing you want to remember is that degrees are just pieces of paper, and pieces of paper are just pieces of paper. What degrees stand in for is they stand in for competence. They signify to everyone that this person has some knowledge and is probably going to succeed in that line of employment or in that line of work or whatever line that that area of study is preparing you for. But they're a proxy for competence, they're not competence itself. And so whenever you're going through your education at whatever level, you always need to be asking the question, okay, yes, I'm working for the proxy of competence, I'm working for the degree, but what is competence for me in this area? What would competence look like for me? At the end of this field of study, at the end of my degree program, what sorts of skills do I want to have, and what kind of person do I want to be, and what experiences do I want to have had and have available to me in the future? And if you can keep yourself focused on those sorts of questions, then you can make sure that pursuing your degree, getting that nice diploma on the wall, never gets in the way of what's most important, which is cultivating who you are as a person. Another thing that you want to think about as you pursue this kind of goal is that you've already defined, okay, I don't want to just get a diploma. Instead, I want a certain set of competencies and character traits. Very good. Now the next question is, the course of study that I'm pursuing, whatever classes I have to take, whatever work I have to do, whatever course objectives there are, how can I make those work as effectively as possible for my goals? One way that I've applied that in my last program, my Master's of English program, was ensuring that whenever I was writing my final paper for the course, and actually my program was kind of designed this way, it was the kind of paper that could be presented at an academic conference. So every semester I was writing out ideas that would exist outside of the classroom. They weren't just for my professor, they were the kinds of ideas that I could go and present at an academic conference to other people. In other words, I was always ensuring that the work I was doing in my course was serving some kind of real-world purpose that harmonized with my goals. So that's the second tip that I want to give, is ensure that the coursework that you do works for you, not against you. Third, and perhaps most importantly, you want to ensure that you never, ever, ever do something that you don't believe in and that you can't commit to. What that ends up looking like is that sometimes you're in classes and you feel like you have to do stupid projects that are useless. If you can, don't do the stupid project. I've actually done that a couple times and my grades have, you know, not suffered too much, and when they have suffered for it, it's been worth it, frankly. Another place where that pops up is that depending on the ideological bent of your professors, you may feel pressured to write things that you don't believe in. Now, you have to engage with ideas that you disagree with, but you never, ever, ever want to say things that you don't believe in. Another place where this pops up is, of course, your program as a whole. You want to make sure that whatever you're studying, you're not studying it because it's going to make you a lot of money, and you're not studying it because everyone's telling you to do it, and you're not studying it because you feel like it's a quote-unquote safe option. Instead, you need to always be looking at your course of study and saying, can I commit to this? Can I spend 4 years of my life on this and feel good about myself after that? Can I spend 2 years of my life in a master's program on it and feel good about myself at the end of it? Can I spend 6 years in a PhD program and at the end of it come out and say, yes, I meant to do that, it was worth it, it has made me a more whole and more integrated person? Really, that's what education is about. So many things in our education can distract us from that aim. We have all the requirements of the coursework, you have diploma requirements, you have the whole education system that, like a funnel, kind of squeezes you in and then squeezes you out like a sausage grinder. And it takes a lot of work to resist that, but it's so worth it. It's so worth it to ensure that your education develops you into the kind of person who you want to be with the kinds of traits and competencies that you really want to have. And really, in the end, that's what it's about, is making a conscious decision that's good for you and for everyone else. So there you have it. That's my guide of how to get good grades in school. My grades aren't perfect, but they are pretty good, so I think that this is some pretty solid advice. Most importantly for me, it's made it so that my education has worked for me and been a good thing for me. It hasn't been something I hate, it hasn't been something that's kind of sucked my soul out of me. Instead, it's something that brings me joy. If you haven't checked out the other video where other Joseph talks about how to get bad grades in law school, be sure to check that out here. We'd love for you to leave a comment below telling us how you make your education work for you, or what you're going to do in the future to make your education work for you. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please give us a like and subscribe. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.